and welcome back to the Lunar Witch. Today we are going to be talking about what everybody has been wanting me to do a video on for a very long time, which is how to work with Artemis. Now you're going to notice that my setup is a little bit different today. I wanted to show you guys because I know a lot of you have been really wanting me to do this video for a very long time now. So I wanted to just keep her statue in front of me, and I also wanted to put the deer and the candle lit in front of me as well, because I know that this video has been a long time coming for a lot of people, so I want to make sure that this video is done as correct and precise as I possibly can. Now, one thing I want to nip in the butt before we do anything, before we move forward or anything like that, is this. I do get a lot of comments, whether it be on my TikTok or even when it comes to my YouTube channel, where people think that Artemis only works with females. This is not true. Obviously, I am living proof of that. Artemis was the first deity to ever call out to me, and she is also my matron deity. Now, one of the things you should know, though, is when Artemis does pick a male figure to work with, she is very particular and picky about who she chooses. And this comes with her being a very strong feminine energy who is very empowering to women. So when she does decide to work with a male, it is for a specific reason. First off, if you're a male and she works with you, it's more than likely that you are a male that also is in touch with your femininity or feminine side of you. Most males who aren't scared to actually show a feminine side and don't act like macho man Randy Savage every single time they go out somewhere or feel like they can't be cute or anything like that in public to anybody because of the fact that they don't want to screw with their masculinity. This is something that she doesn't like. She doesn't like real masculine, real heavyweight guys that can't be in touch with their feminine side. So if she is choosing to work with you, it is because she sees potential in you, because you do treat women with respect. And when I say treat women with respect, I say that because, again, she is a very woman-empowering deity, someone who is very strong and respectful towards women. So when she does choose you as a male, feel very special about that. I'm saying that because you really should feel special, because she will not choose you or work with you if she doesn't see any potential in you whatsoever. And the same thing goes with women as well. It's a little more difficult for guys because she wants to empower women. But it's a little more difficult for guys because on a guy's sense, masculinity is not something that Artemis protects. It's more feminine energy that Artemis protects and women that Artemis protects, along with children as well. And this is one thing I want to let you guys know as well when it comes to Artemis, is whether you're male or female and you are treating a child with disrespect, she will not work with you, and she will be very angry at you. If she is one of your goddesses and she ever sees whether you are male or female disrespect a child in any way, shape, or form, you are going to feel her wrath because she really is protective of children. So before we get started today, I will let you guys know, just for this video, we are going to be doing a brief history on Artemis. We're going to give you kind of like what her origins are and so on and so forth. And then after that, we're going to get into some offerings, crystals, stuff like that, that you can put on her altar. And then towards the end of this video, I will also show you guys my altar as well, so you guys can kind of get an idea as to how maybe you can set up your altar. But again, when I was explaining that masculine feminine thing, I just want people to know, because that was something that was actually brought to my attention very long ago, that she is a very strong feminine deity that does empower women and children. But if she does choose you as a male, and she does work with males, but I'm saying if she does choose you as a male, you should really feel special about that, because she is choosing you because she knows you are very respectful to women, she knows you're respectful to children, and she also knows that you can be in touch with your feminine side and not be ashamed about that. So again, feel really, really special if she is deciding to work with you as a male. And even as a female, also feel special about that as well, because again, she is a very picky goddess. She's very picky about who she works with. And if she notices that you're a woman who's kind of low on self-confidence or something like that, she will come about and she will help you and she will stay with you to empower you and actually give you that strength to love yourself and give you that self-confidence that you need to boost yourself forward. But again, I'm going on a rant here. So like, she's my matron goddess, and like Anubis and Artemis are my two favorite deities to talk about. So I'm gonna just kind of just go into the history about this, because if I keep talking about it, I'm gonna keep talking about it. This video is gonna be 30, 40 minutes long, and that's not what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to keep everything as informative as possible. So let's get into the history. So Artemis is known as the Greek goddess of the hunt, forests and hills, the moon, archery, and many more things. Artemis is known as the goddess of the hunt and is one of the most respected of all ancient Greek deities. It is thought that her name, and even the goddess herself, may even be pre-Greek. She was the daughter of Zeus, king of the gods, and the titaness Leto, and she has a twin brother, the god Apollo. Not only was Artemis the goddess of the hunt, she was also known as the goddess of wild animals, wilderness, childbirth, and virginity. Also, she was the protector of young children and was known to bring and relieve disease in women. In literature and art, she was depicted as a huntress carrying a bow and arrow. Artemis was a virgin and drew the attention and interest of many gods and men. However, it was only her hunting companion Orion that won her heart. Artemis was a virgin and drew the attention and interest of many gods and men. However, it was only her hunting companion Orion that won her heart. It is believed that Orion was accidentally killed either by Artemis herself or by Gaia, the primordial goddess of the earth. Also, in another version of the story of Adonis, who was the late addition to Greek mythology during the Hellenistic period, Artemis sent a wild boar to kill Adonis after he continued to boast that he was a far greater hunter than her. According to a source, Artemis was born a day before Apollo. She then served as a guardian to him, which provided a context for her desire to protect and nurture. She was primarily a virgin huntress, goddess of wildlife, and patroness of hunters. The bear was sacred to her. She guarded her virginity carefully. Actaeon and Orion tried to dishonor or rape her, but anyone who threatened her purity met with a violent end. She was an important goddess in the lives of women, especially when it came to marriage and young creatures. When one of her nymphs was seduced by Zeus, Artemis transformed her into a bear and then killed her. She was sometimes associated with the goddess of the moon. Artemis acted out in anger whenever her wishes were disobeyed, especially if anyone transgressed against the animals that were sacred to her. She punished Agamemnon, for example, when he killed a stag in her sacred grove. Going into another story about Artemis, there is a story that Apollo and Artemis teamed up to kill the children of Niobe. Niobe bragged that she had birthed more children than Leto, the mother of Apollo and Artemis, and the twins then hunted her children and killed them with their bows and arrows. Artemis was worshipped widely in Greece, but only as a secondary deity. A temple built in her honor became one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. Artemis spent most of her time roaming the forests with her nymphs. She was described as both hunting animals and protecting them. She armed herself with a bow and arrow made by Hephaestus and the Cyclops. So before I move forward with any of the offerings, that was just a brief history on Artemis. I will leave a link down below if you guys want to do a full entire research of Artemis and stuff like that. But that was just facts and also a little bit of history as to how Artemis became known as the Greek deity that she is today. But before I go forward, there is one thing that I also want to tell people, because there is a second version of that story with Orion. Now, as most people know, Orion was the first person, the first and only man to ever get close enough to Artemis's heart in order to not make her pure anymore. Artemis would have lost her virginity to Orion if it wasn't for one specific situation in general. Now, this story goes like this. There is a specific story that indicates that Apollo got very jealous of Artemis and Orion spending time together because Apollo and Artemis used to hunt together as brother and sister. Once Orion and Artemis started spending more time with each other, Apollo got so jealous that one day when Orion was bathing in a lake, he decided to challenge Artemis to a bow and arrow contest to see who was the better archer. Apollo knew that that was Orion, and he allowed Artemis to shoot first, and Artemis ended up hitting Orion and killing him in that same day in the lake. But this is just the second story. If you've seen that story before, I'm sure you know the entire thing. If not, the story is all over the place in Greek mythology. Just go read about it. It really is a very interesting story to hear about the envy and the jealousy and even sometimes the anger of these deities together. So it is very interesting to research. So if you ever get the time to look up that story, I strongly suggest looking that story up. But okay, so let's get into some of the offerings you can give to Artemis. So one of the offerings that I know are the best thing that you can give her crystal-wise are amethyst, moonstone, turquoise, and quartz. Those four crystals right there are something that you can 100% leave on her altar, and she will be excruciatingly and extraordinarily happy about that. I have watched as her candles grew in intensity when I threw those types of crystals onto her altar. When I first created my altars, I noticed that my candle flames were usually very, very small, and it was because my energy and connection towards these deities were very, very minimal at the time because I was just learning how to work with them. But as time went on, as time progressed, and I started getting things that they liked and my energy became more connected to their energy, now that Artemis is my matron deity, you start to see bigger candle flames here, bigger, steadier candle flames that are very, very bright and very beautiful. This signifies a very strong connection between you and your deities. So that brings me to my next point. Candles for your altar. One of the biggest candles that you are going to want to get for your altar starting out is a white candle. Why white? Because Artemis was known as the Virgin Huntress. Since she was known as the Virgin Huntress, white is purity. So to have a white candle would signify that purification or purity of Artemis on your altar. This will definitely be a good candle for you to start out with, but if you want to start getting more in depth with other colors that she might like, go with silver, green, red, yellow, things like of that nature. Definitely put that on her altar as well at some point because she will enjoy that. Now I know you guys are probably looking at this one and seeing that it's a midnight blue color. This was a test run that I actually did like a week ago because I just bought these ones because they didn't have silver anymore, which was really, really frustrating. But the only reason I got this one was because I thought midnight blue, kind of like the night sky when the moon is like really, really bright, you see that really dark, beautiful blue color of the sky. That's why I got this candle, and thankfully she liked it when I put it on her altar because I was really, really hoping she didn't hate it, and she did like it. So if you are going to try things out with your deity, you will know when that deity does not like specific offerings when you do put them on your altar, because you'll probably see that the candle flames on your altar will start to go insane. You could also ask your deity on like a pendulum or anything like that before you go and buy something if they would like a specific thing. I didn't do that. I was already out. I was already driving and I didn't have my pendulum with me, and I just had this really deep thought that I was like, you know, she would really, really like this dark blue midnight sky colored candle. And I turned out to be right. So sometimes you just have to trust your intuition when it comes to offerings for your deities. But I will tell you that if a deity does not like specific offerings, you will know because your candle flames will go very erratic. You might have a very, very small candle flame. You might notice like your candle flames one day will be very big and beautiful like this, and then say you go out, you buy something they don't like, and you put it on the altar. You might notice that your candle flames start to bounce around a lot, or maybe the candle flame will start to die out a lot. This is something or a signification that your deity is trying to tell you that they don't like something that you put on their altar. So just pay attention to that. That's why I always tell you guys to pay attention to candle flames, and that's why I have a video out on my channel on how to read chandel. Did I say chandel? I have a video out on my channel that is how to read candle flames. So if you guys don't know how to read candle flames yet, I would strongly suggest going and checking out that one because that will strongly help you work with the deity that you work with. But yes, those are going to be the types of candles. You got your green, you got your yellow, you got your silver, you got your red. You can put those candles on there. You also got your white candle, and I do believe that I mentioned the crystals already. You got your moonstone, you got your quartz, you got your turquoise, you got your amethyst. Those are all crystals as well that you can put straight on her altar, and those are going to be things that you can 100% start off with, and she will be very appreciative of those offerings that you have. But for all you other witches out there that might be doing like herbs and stuff like that, there are two big ones that I have come across, but there are a couple other ones as well. There's an oil that I got that I was told about. Moonflower oil is something that you can put on a charcoal disc when you have it in the cauldron as an offering to her. You can also use wormwood, mugwort, and jasmine. These are all things that she would love as offerings and that you can put in the cauldron as an offering to Artemis if you are working with her. And towards the end of this video, I will give you guys a brief description as to everything that I went over in here so you guys can just make sure that you're refreshed and you're ready to go if you are going to work with her. But one thing I do want to tell you guys is if you're trying to communicate with her or if you're trying to have some sort of communication in general, meditation, that's definitely your biggest thing to go. If you're going to do candle readings, make sure that you have a candle and you definitely research or look into that video that I have on my YouTube about how to read candle flames. You can also use your pendulum, you can use your tarot decks, you can use all of those things to communicate with her, but just make sure 100% when you are trying to communicate with that specific deity, make sure that your intent is focused 100% on working with that deity. I cannot stress that enough, because there are other spirits and entities out there. I want you guys to know that when you speak into the spirit realm, when you speak into a completely different plane, you are talking to everything. And if you are trying to specifically put your intention towards one thing, make sure you are 100% focused and concentrated that you are trying to talk to Artemis herself. The major way that I knew Artemis was trying to communicate with me in general was when I was first living out where I was when I was out for work, they moved me all the way across New York State. So I was in a small town, and one day I was just getting into witchcraft. I remember that I was very, very new, and I was working with spirits and my spirit guides and stuff like that, but I had not yet worked with deities. Now, when I first moved there, there was no sign of deer around my apartment whatsoever. I was literally sitting in my apartment one day, probably about 6-7 months in to living in that place, and I started noticing deer were starting to lay down right outside my window. They weren't coming over there to feed. They weren't coming over there to do anything. Deer were literally coming out of the woods and laying in front of my window and just sitting there all night. And they wouldn't move. They wouldn't do anything. They would just sit right there. And also, as much as I thought that that was weird and cool at the same time, I didn't really think much of it until one day I was at work, and I went to work, and I was in this job called mobile. Now, this is where you take a car and a vehicle and you go around the building and make sure that everything is secure and everything like that. The one day I was going around, there were deer everywhere. They were coming out of the woods. They were laying down on the grass. Every path that I took had a deer laying down, staring at the path that I was driving on. And when I went inside, I talked to somebody and I said, "It's so weird. All these deer are outside, just like it feels like they're staring at me as I'm going by." And the person literally said to me, "Huh, that really is weird, because usually when the mobile goes by, they all run away into the woods. They don't ever come out this way because they're too scared of the noises." And I said, "That's incredible." I used to get out of my vehicle, and I used to bring apples to work. Like, when I noticed that they were actually coming outside and they were actually like staying out there, I used to bring just chunks of apple with me, and I would go out. They would walk right up to me. They would eat right from my hand. It was insane. And then finally, I went to a crystal shop one day, and I spoke to a high priestess, and I told her about this, and she said, "Have you ever come to the conclusion, or have you ever maybe had any dreams about a female holding a bow and arrow, like ever walking with deer?" And I said, "Now that you mention it, I did have a dream not too long ago about this female. She was standing in a woods with a bunch of deer around her, and she said, 'Artemis is calling out to you.' She goes, 'I felt the energy as soon as you walked in here that there was some deity that was with you at that point in time.'" So this was my story about how I actually found out that Artemis was connecting with me in some sort of way. So if you are looking to see if she is trying to contact you in some way, shape, or form, look out for deer. Look out for her appearing in dreams or meditations or anything like that. But that was my story. I'm sure other people have stories as well when it comes to their stuff. We're going to recap a little bit here. I want you guys to know that, again, crystals that you can get for her are moonstone, quartz, turquoise, and amethyst. Herbs you can use for her are mugwort, wormwood, and jasmine. And an oil you can use as well is moonflower oil. When it comes to candles and candle colors, you got white, you got silver, you've got green, you've got yellow, and you've got red. These are all candles that you can put on her altar for her as well. And also, as you can see in front of me, I have this deer right here, this little deer candle holder that's right there. Little knickknacks like that are also something that your deities will really, really love when you do stuff and create altars for them. So guys, just going into the altar here, like I told you, this is the Artemis statue that I got right here. You've got a bunch of the crystals that I told you about surrounding her altar itself, or surrounding her statue, I would say. You got the candles on here that I told you about. You got the deer holder on here, which is one of her sacred animals. You got a bunch of moonstone crystals right there that I have. And you also have a Herkimer. Herkimer was one of just the ones that I put on there for extra energy, and I used the moonstones to surround it. So she was very happy about that when I did that. And then also, if you go below here, you'll see that I got like a little forest set up. I got the wolves. I got a wolf's little statue back there. I got other moonstones on here as well. That's Rainbow Moonstone in the front right there that you see. There's two little white dots. Those are Rainbow Moonstone. And in the back are just little offerings that I've done as well. That's a recharge station for some of my crystals and certain things like that. And as on the outside you can see, I got a lot of foresty looking stuff on here just to symbolize the woods and all that stuff. So this is definitely something that you guys can look into. And if you guys did need a couple ideas for an altar, I just wanted to show you guys how mine was set up here so it could give you guys a little bit of an idea as to what you could do as well. So everybody, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video today. I tried to make this video as clear and precise as I possibly could make it because I know this has been a video for a lot of people and a very long time coming. So I really appreciate anybody that has come and seen this video and watched it. If you guys did enjoy this video, make sure you leave a like and make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also leave a comment down in the comment section if you guys have any questions. I'll be more than happy to answer it. And until next time, I will see you here on the Lunar Witch. So good to be back. We'll be right back.